Welcome to Study With Me, Scapula Part 2. So in this part, we will cover more on the attachment of the muscle. So as usual, we have the anterior view, the posterior view. Alright, for the anterior view, we have here is the ventral surface, where we know there is a subscapular fossa. There is also a muscle over there. We call it as subscapularis muscle. It takes the name from the subscapular fossa. Alright, so this one is from the 3D view. Alright, from the anterior view and the side view. Alright, moving on to the superior border, we have suprascapular notch and also suprascapular nerve. There is also a suprascapular ligament overhead the suprascapular notch. Alright, from the 3D view. Yep, and then moving on to the medial border, there is a attachment for serratus anterior muscle. It takes up from the superior angle down to the inferior angle. So this one is the serratus anterior muscle, where it attaches from the medial border and then attached to the ribs. Nothing much about the lateral border because there is subscapularis muscle that attached there. So then we go to the lateral angle at the supraglenoid tubercle and infraglenoid tubercle. At the supraglenoid tubercle, there is bicep brachii muscle. For the infraglenoid tubercle, there is tricep brachii muscle. To make it easier to remember, so try to remember that B always comes before T. Moving on to the Karaka process, at the tip of the Karaka process, there is bicep and coracobrachialis muscle that attach there. The long head of the bicep will attach at the supraglenoid tubercle, and also the long head of the tricep will attach at the infraglenoid tubercle. At the Karaka process, the short head of the bicep will attach there. At the medial border of the Karaka process, there is another muscle we call pectoralis minor muscle. Right, this is the 3D view. This one showing the tricep brachii muscle that attach at the infraglenoid tubercle. The coracobrachialis and the short head of the bicep that attach at the coracoid process. Next to it is the pectoralis minor muscle. And at the supraglenoid tubercle, there is the long head bicep brachii. That Karaka process, we have the tip, the lateral border, the medial border, and part where the Karaka process start to curve. There are ligaments that will attach at each part. Medial part, the coracoid will attach with the ribs, so we call it costal coracoid ligament. At the lateral, there is two ligaments that will attach in between coracoid to the acromion, which we call it coracoacromial ligament, and between the coracoid and the humerus, we call it coracohumeral ligament. Part where the coracoid process take the curve, ligament that will attach in between the coracoid and the clavicle above, we call it the coracoclavicular ligament. And it have two parts. We call it the trapezoid part. It takes the shape of the trapezium, and the conoid part. The conoid means it takes the shape of the cone. So this one is the coracoacromial ligament. This is the coracohumeral ligament. So this one is the coracoclavicular ligament. the conoid part. And this one is the trapezoid part. Alright, so that's all from me. Thank you so much for watching. So don't forget to catch up my next video. Thank you.